Hello everybody, welcome to the CSS3 course. This video is going to talk about mainly advanced selectors. For example, I can specify the descendant selectors together with the direct child selector and the sibling selector. I'm also able to specify the adjacent sibling selectors. And before I talk about all these selectors, I would like to talk about the two important identifiers in HTML. The first one is known as a division, which is having div as the element name. A division here simply means a block level element for setting up the styles. So a div element doesn't give any semantic meaning to the web page. If we want to simply change the style of a certain part of your web page, you can enclose the parts with a pair of div tags. The element inside the div tags will be having other kinds of treatment as specified by your CSS file. So I'm going to set up a division which would cover a lot of elements. I have about more than 10 lines being included in my division tags. And inside the division, I have another important identifier to discuss now. I have a span element here. A span element is pretty similar to a division element. A span element means an inline element inside the paragraph for setting up the styles. So a span element takes up the necessary space only. It is not really treated as a block level element as a division element does. Okay. So it is usually used in a portion of a certain element. So what does it mean by that? We can see the situation on the right hand side of the screen. So for this part, this part is actually enclosed by the span element, and I'm going to change the effect of this element on the CSS file. But we have to remember that this span element is really inside the paragraph element shown here. Okay, so how can I really specify this span element? I have to really understand one thing. This span element is inside a paragraph, so we can treat the span element as the descendant of the paragraph element. So how can I really specify this span element? Let me go to the CSS file. Okay, when I want to specify the span element which is inside a paragraph element, I can do something like this. Okay, I can just use a space to separate two elements. So in this case, I'm able to specify the span element which is inside the paragraph element. So we can say that the span element is a descendant of the paragraph element. So if I want to really do this kind of descendant selectors, we just need a space in between the parent element together with the descendant element. So we can see that the font size is altered by the CSS file. And we have to notice one important property. A descendant selector would affect all the children and their grandsons. So what does it mean by that? We can see an example like this one. Okay, we can see that the block quote specified by the division.class1 element will be turned to a yellow-green background. So why is it important to understand this property? Because when we look at the web page on the right hand side of the screen, we can see that two block quotes would have this same background color. And what's the reason for that? We can take a look at the HTML file. The HTML file has a definition called class 1, which is simply the style that I'm going to handle. And inside this definition element, I really have one block quote followed by another block quote, which is actually inside another division. And this division is really nested in the outer division element. So we can see that the descendant selector affects all the children. Why? Because when I just want to change the first block quote background color, I'm also able to change the background of the second block quote, which is inside another division element, which is a nested division element of the outer division element. So in this case, so when I just want to change the block quote specified the division.class1, I'm also able to affect the children and the grandsons of the original block quote element that is just inside the outer division element. Okay. So even though the block quote element, which is inside the inner division element, is regarded as the children of the original outer division element, its color is also affected by the instructions set to the parent elements. So you can see that the second block quote is also turned to yellow-green background. So this is an important property of descendant selectors. It really affects all the children and the grandsons, even though they are enclosed by another level of the division element. Okay. And then I'm going to talk about the direct child combinator in view of this troublesome situation of selecting all the children and the grandsons when I just want to specify one particular element. So how can we make use of the direct child combinator to avoid this kind of possible problem with the style ruling issue? I can do something like this. Okay, we can simply use the closing angle bracket as the direct child combinator. So in this case, I'm just going to locate the block quote, which is the direct child of my class 1 division. So when I look back to the HTML file, I'm just going to locate the block quote element, which is this one, which is the one just inside the outer division element, and the one which is another level of the division element, which is known as the nested division element, will not be chosen. Okay, so I'm going to just locate the very direct child of the element inside the outer division element. Okay, so I'm going to avoid the effect on another block quote, which is not the direct child of my current division element. Okay. And then I would like to show the multi-level child combinator. So what does it mean by that? As we create our own web pages, we will see that there are so many levels of elements by using the spaces as the indicator. So when we want to drill very deep to some particular elements to apply our styles, how can we do that? We can consider using the multi-level child selector. So let me show you an example here. Okay, what does it mean by the multi-level child selector? We can see on the web page on the right hand side that the background color of a certain list item has turned to yellow. So what does it mean by that? We can go to the division with class name called class 2. And inside this division, we have so many levels of elements. For this case, I have the outer ordered list, which has an inner ordered list. So when I want to really locate the list item inside the inner ordered list, I'm able to do so by using so many closing angle brackets as the directions to guide me towards the required elements. So we can go over the flow like this. Division with name class 2, and then we go to the ordered list, and we go to the ordered list which is inside the outer ordered list, and inside the inner ordered list, I'm going to locate the li element here. So by means of the angle brackets, the closing angle brackets, in this way, we are able to locate the multi-level child very precisely. So after that, I would like to talk about general siblings combinator. So what does it mean by this word siblings? We can see an example on my web page. So let me go to this section. And the code corresponding to this section is here. Suppose I focus on h2 element here. The elements following this h2 element are known as the siblings of the h2 element. So this paragraph and this paragraph are known as the siblings of the h2 element. Okay, and the element above the h2 element is not regarded as the sibling of the h2 element. So this line is above the element h2. So this paragraph is not regarded as a sibling of h2. So only the elements below the particular element in focus are regarded as the siblings. And we have to notice something as well. If I have a division followed by my paragraph, which is a sibling of the H2 element, the elements inside this division are not regarded as the direct siblings of the H2 element, which is this one, okay? So as long as we have another division inside my previous division, the contents inside this inner division are not regarded as this direct siblings of the H2 element. So in this case, only these two paragraphs will be regarded as the siblings of the H2 element. So when I want to really specify these two general siblings of the H2 element, how can I do that? I can do something like this on the CSS file. Okay, class 3 is simply the division encloses the H2 heading. And in this way, with the tilde character, I'm able to specify the paragraphs which are the siblings of the H2 element. So we go to the division which has a name called class 3. And in this division, I look for the H2 element, and when I have the tilde character, I'm able to locate the siblings of the H2 elements. So I would be able to locate this paragraph and that paragraph. And you can see on the right-hand side that the two paragraphs have changed their font to monospace. And we can see that the paragraph following the two direct siblings will not be changed to the monospace font because they are not regarded as the direct siblings of the H2 element. Okay, so this is the way we can control the general siblings by means of the tilde character being the combinator that joins the parent element H2. Okay. And finally, I would like to say something about the adjacent siblings combinator. So what is the meaning of an adjacent sibling combinator? I would like to simply select the adjacent sibling of a certain element without changing the styles of other siblings. So the adjacent sibling simply means the first sibling just after the element before the plus sign. So I will demonstrate the usage of this sibling combinator. So when I go to the part that corresponds to the adjacent sibling, I have two block quotes. And if I focus on H2, I would have two siblings. One is the first block quote, the other one is the next block quote. And the adjacent sibling simply means the first block quote element. So this is the first sibling of the H2 element, while the second block quote is not the adjacent sibling corresponding to the H2 element. So in order to only change the style of the first block quote, which is the adjacent sibling of H2, how can I do so? I can do something like this on the CSS file. Okay, I have a typo, so it should be B-L-O-C-K-Q-U-O-T-E. So we can see that the block quote, which is the adjacent sibling of the H2 element, has turned the background color to orange. And I'm not able to affect the background color of the other sibling, which is not the adjacent one, because of the plus combinator here. I'm able to just control the background color of the adjacent sibling instead of all the siblings that follows H2 element. So this is the general idea of making use of the combinators as well as the descendant selector. So we are able to pretty precisely locate the elements in addition to the original selectors that we know already. For example, the class selector, ID selectors, and so on. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.